We've all been learning about space and the commercialization of space, but we've been hearing about it and learning about it through the lens of Richard Branson, Elon Musk, and Jeff Bezos. What people don't realize, Brian, is that organizations like Spaceflight Industries that you've built are building whole new industries around what we're going to be doing in space. You've been at it for 30 years. You've seen the ins and outs. Where do you see the future of space taking us?
Yeah, the future of space is really what is going to happen when there's a lot more satellites up there collecting a lot more information, whether it's observing the Earth with imaging capability or listening to signals or using radar to look at weather. Where this is really going is it's moving from just a handful of very big, expensive satellites to swarms of little satellites that are collecting an immense amount of data at very high frequencies to give you extremely new insights about what is happening to our planet.
And to put that into perspective, costs were in the hundreds of millions, billions of dollars. Now, in your business, you're talking about $10 million or less. That has enabled a whole proliferation of these small satellites.
That's right. That's right. Years ago, some of the imagery that was on Google Maps was taken with a $1 billion satellite. Today, we're producing the same level of imagery for a satellite that costs less than $10 million and is about the size of a dorm room refrigerator.
And you can design them much more quickly. Your design cycle has been shortened a lot as well.
The old model was those satellites took 5 years to build. They'd go into space for 10 or 12 years, so you had 17-year-old technology. With these satellites now, you can design and upgrade the technology in 12 to 18 months, put them up in space for 3 years, and then refresh it.
And what do you think the killer app could be?
I think what's going to be interesting is we'll have the ability to monitor the Earth in almost near real time, which means we will understand what goes on in some of the most important places around the world continuously, which is going to mean we understand what normal is and abnormal, which is going to get us into a world of predictive analytics. We're going to be able to understand when things are changing and then how to respond to those changes in a way that helps a range of new industries as well as, you know, humankind.
And so getting the images with that new level of frequency, that it's a true real-time, virtual real-time monitoring, you're launching 16 satellites to do that. How does that come together?
The company is about 5 years into building this constellation. We've had about $200 million of investment to build not only the spacecraft, but an entire AI machine learning processing system and a cloud computing environment to distribute the data worldwide.
And it's a point-and-shoot technology. Flying overhead, program it to take a shot of something specific and repeat that.
They're almost like flying webcams. They're up on these satellites, and you can, from your browser, tell it where you want to take a picture, and it will steer the satellite, take the picture, and send it back to you and get it back in your inbox on your phone or on your PC.
And who are kind of the early adopters, do you see, of this kind of data?
Obviously, there's a lot of applications in the government. We've been doing work with immigration. A lot of that is trying to figure out where might some of these groups be assembling, and do they have enough resources, and where might they be going next? So there's a lot of organizations working on that problem. Another area is in illegal and unregulated fishing. It's a multi-billion dollar problem for the global economy.